Hi there. Today we're going to be using the fx-300ESPlus2 scientific calculator from Casio to show you a couple ways that you could solve for equations that have fractions in them. So we're going to use this example over here on the right to show you two different ways that you could use this scientific calculator to solve this equation. One way would be to actually just solve it the way you normally would, right? By isolating the variable x. And so I'm going to use this box to just show you how you would work it out on paper, but then how you could use the calculator to support you with the fractions. So the first thing you'd want to do is obviously we're going to isolate the x. So you want to get this subtract 5 or add negative 5. You'd want to use the inverse. So add positive 5 to both sides. So that's this first step. And on my calculator, I'm just going to go right to that answer here. So I'm going to use the fractions without having to convert that into a decimal form. I can use the fraction because if you look over here on the left at the calculator, there is a template for fractions. And so this makes working with fractions very easily. So I'm going to enter negative 5/8. I'm going to actually do the calculation with my calculator right here. So I'm going to enter the negative symbol, and then I can either hit the template first and enter my 5 and then use my toggle key to get down to my 8. And now add positive 5 to it. I don't have to do any conversions, and I hit equals and I get the answer in mixed number, which is fine because I'm going to work with that and show you the end result at the end. So now I go down to the next step in this, and here's my 35/8. And then the next step is to multiply by the reciprocal of 1/2 to isolate the x. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 2/1. So that's this work. So now I can take this answer and let's just do 35. And now the template, if I hit the template now, it automatically puts my first number on the numerator section and then 8. And then we're going to do times and let's do 2. Fraction template over 1, or I could have just done 2, and hit equals. And here is my solution. So what I want to show you is I get my solution in fraction form, and it simplified it automatically for me. If you had just multiplied 35 by 2 and 70, 8 times 1, 8, that's where the 70/8. The calculator is going to put the fraction in its simplest form. And then if you need it in its mixed number form, here's where the template comes into handy again. And you're going to you'll see that this is in improper fraction. So we're going to above my S to D button. I see that I can change it to a mixed numeral. So I have to hit the shift button, then my S to D. And that's where this 8 3/4 comes from. And I can also convert it to its other form, which is its decimal equivalent. So I just hit the S to D problem. And that's where the 8.75 comes from. So here is my solution to this problem that had fractions, but with the ability to have fraction templates very easily used, that's one way to solve it. So actually solve it, but using your fraction templates. Another way you could solve it, which would be a little more time consuming, sort of just depends. If we go into the mode of our calculator, and instead of going into the computation mode, which is where we were with this one, we go into the table, and we actually enter each side of the equation, of this equation, as a separate equation. So we're going to enter 1/2 x - 5. Again, having the template makes it easy. So I'm going to do 1 fraction template 2. There's my 1/2. And now I'm going to use my x variable. On this calculator, to get the x variable, you're going to use the alpha key. So alpha close parentheses gives you the x. And then subtract 5. That's my 1 function. And then my second function is just the solution on the other side, so -5/8. So I'm going to hit my negative symbol, and let's do 5 fraction template over 8. So I've entered each side of this equation as a separate equation. So I'm going to hit equals, and it's going to ask me where to start. So it's going to give me basically a table of values, and I'm looking for where the solution might be. So do I think the solution's negative? Is this x going to be negative? Is it positive? Is it going to be a large number or a small number? I think it's going to be kind of large just because we're subtracting a very large number. So this number here must be pretty large because I'm going to subtract. So let's start at 3. So that means it's going to start with values of x that are at 3. We're going to hit enter. We're going to have our table end. Let's say we have our table end at 10. And we want to go by, I have fractions, so maybe I want to go up by 5 to begin. And so now it's going to list those values with x input as 3. And I'm looking for, how do I find a solution when I'm given a table? I'm looking for where the functions have the same solution. That's my answer. So I'm going to scroll through. Did I get anywhere close? I'm getting closer. And it looks like it's going to be somewhere between 8.5 and 9. So I need to go back and change my table of values and maybe change the start value. So let's change the start. We said it's going to be between 7 and 8. So let's put the start value at 7. And let's make it still end at 10. But instead of going by 0.5, let's make it go by 0.25 because my decimals weren't quite small enough. So we're going to hit equals. And now let's scroll through and see if we can get to a point where they are exactly the same. And here is the exact same answer. And that's a value of 8x being 8.75, which matches what we got when we solved it. So using a table is another way you could use the scientific calculator. It's a little more work, but actually is interesting because it really helps you think about the value of x and what that means. So two different ways you could solve a function that has fractions in it using your scientific calculator. This one is the 300ES Plus2 Casio scientific calculator.